Hello everyone, this is the Kyoritsu Q-Snap-6 analog clamp meter, a Japanese branded clamp meter model number 26088 that's made in Thailand. The box contains the user's manual in Japanese and English, the certificate of conformity, and a host of other documents. A high quality and flexible Kyoritsu branded test leads with sleeve protectors, soft carrying case with a zipper that looks durable, and the instrument itself, the Kyoritsu Q-Snap 2608A. I think that the jaws of this clamp meter were designed very well. It makes a definite snapping sound when you move it. The lower portion is fixed and the upper portion is movable, and this should make it easier to clamp conductors to be measured. The upper portion of the function dial represents the scale for the alternating current measurement from 300 maximum to a minimum of 6 amperes AC. The lower portion represents the ranges for the AC voltage readings for 600 maximum of 600 volts down to a minimum of 150 volts AC. There is one setting for DC voltage, and that is 60 volts, and two settings for resistance or continuity, a multiplier of 10 and a multiplier of 1. There is also a temperature setting there, provided you have the necessary or correct temperature test leads, which I did not have. The analog display of this instrument is very clear and white. There is a scale, the black scale for current, the red scale for voltage, and the black scale in the middle for the resistance, and on the upper portion there is also a scale for the temperature. 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50, those numbers are offset in space only, so you might want to take that into account when making a reading between those numbers, as the instrument offset those numbers to make the numbers there aligned to organize them better. This is the adjuster to reset the resistance of the test leads to zero. This analog clamp meter has a hold function which freezes the needle, allowing the user to read the values on the scale. But notice how it does that. When I slide this hold slider, the whole of the analog display, the white analog display, moves up and rests on the needle. This kind of hold action may not appeal to everyone, but at least it makes reading the scale easier, as there is less parallax errors as possible. The small plastic screw there can be used to adjust the pointer to the zero position when it is at rest. And this is, of course, the lock or the hold button. Unlike some multimeter or clamp meter, the connections for the test leads are arranged in a vertical position. Strap attachment to provide the instrument with some protection against accidental falls. The compartment for the 1.5 volt battery, compartment for the fuse protection. This is the contact for the function dial, and in the upper portion that would be the current transformer coil of the instrument. And one good thing about this clamp meter is that it is provided with a spare ceramic fuse rated at 500 milliampere and 600 volt. So if in case the main fuse here blows up, you can at least replace it immediately with the spare fuse. The whole body of the instrument is made of hard plastic. There are no rubberized armor of any sort, so you have to be very careful that you don't drop this clamp meter. There is no on-off switch, so just put back the function dial to 600 volts after its use before safekeeping. using my electrical demonstration board. Let's see how well the Kyoritsu analog clamp meter measures AC voltage. I'm now going to switch the circuit breaker that supplies this outlet and let's compare the readings. The meter here reads 230 volts. The digital meter reads 230 volts. And the Kyoritsu analog clamp meter reads also 230 volts. Exactly. I have here a switching power adapter with a rated 12 volt DC voltage output. So I have set my instrument to read the DC voltage at the scale of DC 60 volts. Reading the instrument can be quite confusing if you are not familiar with the way the instrument scale was designed. In fact, the instrument made a correct reading of 12 volts DC. So that's 12.37 volts DC. That is practically the same value as the one taken by the analog meter, the Q Snap 2608A, which was also 12 volt DC, slightly above 12 volt DC. I'm not really fond of those offset numbers there, and although the analog display is very clear, the numbers are well written, reading the scales here initially needs getting used to. Perhaps the best thing I like about the Kyosnap 2608A is that it gives me reliable results. I'm not saying that it is as accurate as true RMS digital multimeters, but within the limitations of an analog averaging multimeter like the Kyosnap 2608A, for as long as you use it within its limits and being mindful of those specifications, based on my test, the instrument provided me with results that are reliable.